And Dr. Patrick Allen from Falls Road Animal Hospital is here to answer your pet questions with this cutie pie, Knuckles, who is 6 months.
Yeah, little Knuckles, 6 months, Boston Terrier. Knuckles was actually born deaf, which kind of brings up a unique point with dogs as far as different types of disabilities they may have, deafness, blindness. Mm-hmm. We certainly have a lot of dogs that maybe lose a leg to different injuries and trauma.
And you said this one doesn't really set him back much.
Well, that's the thing. We always try to tell people that, and we all oftentimes attach our emotional attachment to things like that to them. They don't necessarily have that, and they cope very well. They do very well. As long as they've got a loving family, take care of them, they do great.
Yeah. All right. Well, good news. Let's get to some questions. We have a few of them. The first one, I just read about an outbreak of a disease called leptospirosis in Detroit. Can you tell me what this is and if all dogs should be vaccinated for it here in Maryland?
Yeah, that's actually a great question. Lepto is a huge issue. Really, around Baltimore is a big issue. And it's a bacteria that is spread by rats and other animals out in the wild through their urine. And they will contaminate the environment. Say we have a storm, it rains, puddles form, dogs drink out of the puddles, walk through the puddles, lick their paws, they then pick up the bacteria. And the bacteria, once they pick it up, can cause liver and kidney failure.
Okay.
So it's a pretty
bad one. So
those
are the big telltale signs.
Yeah, I mean, they will come in, it can be a very acute illness for them. They may come in very sick, vomiting, lethargy. You may notice that they're getting a little bit yellow because of their liver issues. But vaccination, definitely.
Okay.
We encourage it for all the dogs around Baltimore.
Great, good to know. I have a cat that is urine marking and scratching. Is there any over-the-counter product to help stop this?
Yeah, sure. There's actually a great product that, and I can't guarantee it's going to work in every pet, but probably a good 50-60% of them, called Feel-Away. And you can certainly pick that up at various pet stores. And it actually looks just like a plug-in air freshener. You plug it in, diffuses pheromones into the environment that help to stop this marking behavior.
Great. I'm always amazed at things like that and how they work. We have an 8-month-old Bernese Mountain Dog that continues to eat dirt and grass when we take her outside to go. She has done this since we got her. She has had no health problems and is very active. Will she outgrow this, or is there something else we should do?
Yeah, it's hard to say if she's going to outgrow it. Those kind of behaviors are very common in a lot of dogs. And, you know, they may outgrow it. It may be something you have to work with a trainer on, but definitely try doing more leash walking versus letting free roam outside, and encourage with treats and things when they're doing good behaviors.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you.
You're
and thanks,
welcome.
Knuckles. What a sweetheart. Oh, I wish I could just take him home. Appreciate your time.